In the previous lecture, we discussed about the electric field in different cases, that is definition of electric field and electric field due to a point charge and electric field due to a number of charges, that is Q1, Q2, Q3, like that up to n number of charges, what is the electric field, and electric field in the case of one charge line of charges, electric field. In the case of line of charges, what is the electric field from along the axis, what is the electric field at a point P is here, what is the electric field. And second case, perpendicular bisector at this point P, what is the electric field. These two cases we discussed in the case of electric field in the previous class. Today we are going to discuss, first of all, what is the work done by electric field, then definition of electric potential and electric potential due to point charge and electric potential due to summation of charges. After that, Gauss theorem, definition of Gauss theorem and proof of Gauss theorem and derivation of Coulomb's law from Gauss theorem. And already you knew from electrostatic force of attraction between the two positive charges, what is the force and what is the electric field, already you knew. And now if I want to move this positive charge, suppose here charge Q and another charge Q naught at a distance R, if I want to move this positive charge from A to B, what is the work done? What is the work done? That is defined as here negative line integral of electric field. Here observe, here this is the negative line integral of electric field. This gives work done when positive charge, unit positive charge move from A to B. Here point A to point B. And now observe here, at the center positive charge plus Q, it is there, and another test positive charge plus Q naught at a distance R from the center. Already you knew this force is in this direction, outward direction, F bar force equal to outward direction. This force already you knew, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q naught by R square. This is from Coulomb's law of attractive forces. And here representing electric field F by Q naught, then F force equal to E into charge Q naught. This force radially outwards. This force is here radially outwards. That is representing here, let Q naught be the test charge in the place of the unit positive charge. The force, observe here, F equal to Q naught into E, acts on the test charge due to the source of the charge plus Q. Due to this charge, force is acting at this point Q naught, that is radially outwards. And it is radially outwards, tends to accelerate the test charge. Now, what is the total work done by this electric field when it is moving from A, point A to point B, point A to point B? That is given by, here observe here, integral dW and integral here E dot dl. Already you knew the equation for electric field, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R, and dl here, observe here, E dot dl, that is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Here in the place of F they substituted E into Q naught. And here observe here, Q Q naught, that is two positive charges Q and Q naught, 4 pi epsilon naught. Here this point you observe here, that is representing from position A to position B. Here from positive charge to this B, it is distance RB, and from positive charge Q to A, it is RA. 1 by RB minus 1 by RA. 1 by RB minus 1 by RA. Now, this equation represents total work done when a positive charge, this positive charge test, this is the positive charge, this is the test charge. This test charge moved from point A to point B. The test charge moved from point A to point B. What is the total work done? That is given by QQ0 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by RB minus 1 by RA. This is the line integral of electric field, otherwise work done by electric field. Work done by the electric field. And the next one is potential. Observe here, this is the equation work done when you move from positive charge from point A to point B. And this equation shows that work done in moving a test charge from point A to point B along any path in an electric field. That means in this here, this from this point to this point, any path like this, any path, this test charge is moving from here to here, that is given by the equation, that is given by the equation. And another point here, that test positive charge, whenever it is moving from point A to point B, that depends on the path. That means when you are calculating electric field from point A to point B, that depends on the actual path followed by point between these two point A and B. That is, line integral of electric field is path independent. And by using this equation, therefore the electric field is conservative field. That means this positive charge here, this is the Q plus Q, this is here Q naught at a distance R. If this positive charge is moving from point A to point B, point A to point B, this is any path by this path or this one, any path it will come. That is independent of the path, that's why it is called as a conservative field. And if it is another case, for example, from here to here, this is the Q and this is the Q naught test charge, this is the positive charge. If the charge is moving from this to here and here, that means charges, what is the work done when electric field taking plus this complete closed path like this? Previously it is from point A to point B along this any path. Now if it is closed path, for example from this point to this point like this closed path, what will happen? The previous case, it is independent of the path, conservative field, independent of the actual path followed between A and B. Now, if it is closed path from point this point to this point, if it is closed path, what will happen? Line integral of electric field over a closed path, it is equal to 0. E dot dl equal to 0. This is another condition satisfied by conservative field. And here you have to observe, line integral of only static electric field is independent of the path followed. However, the line integral of the field due to moving charge is not independent of the path, because the field varies with the time. If it is static electric field, then it is independent of the path. If it is moving charge, then it is not independent of the path. It is not independent of the path because the field varies with the time. That means here both the points, point A and point B, static here. static here. But when you are taking the second case, this is the first case, this is the second case, what will happen whenever we are moving in the closed path? What will happen? Along with the time, electric field also varies. In this direction it is one, and here one, and here one, and here in this, here, like this. If it is varying, varies with the time. Here independent of the path, and here not independent of the path. But electric field is always conservative field. If you are taking any one system, that electric field is always conservative. And this represent, equation represents the work done when test positive charge moving from one point to another points. And another one now, another one is electrostatic potential. First of all, what is the definition of electrostatic potential? Electrostatic potential is a physical quantity which represents the flow of charges from one body to another. If there are two bodies, for example, from here is one body, here it is one A and here it is one B, these two. If test positive charge moving from point A to point B, point A to point B like this, then electrostatic potential represents the flow of charges. This test positive charge, it is moving from here to here like this. This flow of charge from this point to this point, that is given by electrostatic potential. It is a physical quantity that determines the degree of electrification of a body. And how you are representing this electrostatic potential? Electrostatic potential, see, electrostatic potential at a point in the electric field is defined as the work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinite to that point against the electrostatic force. Observe here one test positive charge is there, and here one test charge plus Q, and here another positive charge Q naught. When you are considering the force, that is always in this direction, F equal to test charge into E bar. Now, how you are define this electrostatic potential? Electrostatic potential defined as, for example, this test positive charge is at a distance infinite, R equal to infinite. How much work is done in order to bring this positive charge from infinite distance to here, near to this positive charge? That is given by electrostatic potential. Electrostatic potential at a point in the electric field is defined as the work done in moving or bringing unit positive charge from infinite. Here we are considering this is infinite. This infinite distance to here, this point. How much work is done from here to here? So electrostatic potential is defined as what is the work done in order to bring unit positive charge from infinite distance to a point charge here. Observe here what is the work done. This is positive charge Q plus Q, and another positive charge Q naught. This is a test charge. For example, another positive charge. How you are going to represent electrostatic potential in equation form? Observe here, already you know how much work done in order to bring the unit positive charge from infinite distance to closed distance. Here already this is the equation given by when you are bringing the unit positive charge from infinite distance to closed distance, and already you know this is the equation. This is when we are considering two charges separated by a distance, at a distance two charges from A to B. Here from A to B, this is the path A here, and this is B here. In that case, equation is work done by bringing positive charge from A to B. In that case, equation is given by E dot dl, that is Q Q naught 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by RB minus 1 by RA. Otherwise, work done divided by unit positive charge 1 Q 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by RB minus 1 by RA. Now, according to this electrostatic electric potential definition, here RA is infinite. That means one point is at a distance, infinite distance. One point here r equal to infinite, and here positive charge is there. This positive charge is Q naught. Q here this is the Q naught. This test charge, in order to bring from infinite distance to close to this positive charge here. Now here instead of RA position A, we are taking infinite distance. RA equal to infinite and RB equal to R. Substitute these two, RA is infinite and RB equal to R in this equation. Then we will get it. Work done divided by positive charge Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R. This equation represents electric potential. And what is the SI unit of this electrostatic electric potential is? It is represented by V volt, otherwise joules per coulomb, otherwise Newton meter per coulomb. And electric potential at a point is 1 volt if 1 joule of work is done in moving 1 coulomb of charge from infinite to that point in that electric field. Here, electric potential is defined as when positive charge bringing from infinite distance to near to the test positive charge is bringing from infinite distance to near to the positive charge divided by positive charge that is Q naught. This is also definition for electric potential. Electric potential is a physical quantity which represents flow of charge from one body to another body. This is about electric potential, and the equation for electric potential is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. Now, what is the electric potential when you are considering one, if it is two points, for example, up to now we are calculating from bringing that R equal to infinite to this positive charge here Q naught. Here there are two charges instead of one, two. What is this potential difference? Electric potential difference. Electric potential difference between any two points in the electric field is the defined as the work done in moving unit positive charge from one point to other against the electrostatic force, irrespective of the path followed. For example, here, in order to bring this positive charge from here to here, whenever you are considering this test charge and positive charge, force is in this direction. Force is always in this direction. Against to this force, we are bringing this test charge from this point to here. Now, in the definition already we knew, we are bringing from unit positive charge from infinite to certain distance, that is electric potential. Now, here in this, I am considering one system. For example, here, one system A and B. Now, what is the work done in order to bring unit positive charge between these two points, that is given by electric potential difference. Observe here, equation is E dot dl, that is Q Q naught by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by RB 1 by RA. Otherwise, this is electric potential definition. Double work done for unit positive charge 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by RB minus 1 by RA. Now, Here, observe if it is V suffix A, two points here, A and B, in order to bring the test charge, what is the equation for VA? That is electric potential at a point A, and electric potential at a point B. This is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R A, and another one is VB at this point 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R B. Now, what is the difference between this point A and point B? That is given by electric potential difference between the two points. Here, that equation is there, Vb minus Va, Vb minus Va, that one, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Rb, 1 by Rb minus Q by 4 pi epsilon 1 by Ra. Vb minus Va, this is the electric potential difference, that is represented by delta V, del V, and work done, Wab represents how much work is done in order to bring the positive charge from this point in this system. That is Wab divided by this unit charge. This is electric potential difference between the two points. If you are considering the system, don't confuse here. Potential difference is electric potential we are defining. Whenever unit positive charge, we are bringing from infinite distance to near to this positive charge. That is electric potential. And electric potential difference is defined as, if you are considering one system, for example, here this is A, this is B, these are the two points. How much work is done in order to bring the unit positive charge in this system? That is given by here Wab divided by Q naught, electric potential difference between the two points. Observe here, electric potential and potential difference are both are scalar quantities. Some points note down, electric potential and potential difference both are scalar quantities. Electric potential at any point at infinity is zero. That means electric potential here in the system we are representing point A and point B. If it is this one R equal to infinite distance, then 1 by infinity this becomes equation becomes 0, then electric potential also 0 at infinity. Electric potential near an isolated positive charge, if it is charge is positive, and that an isolated negative charge, that is negative. If the test charge is positive, then potential also positive. If the test charge is negative, then the potential also negative. And unit already you knew, CCS unit is volt, that is represented by V, and 1 volt equal to 1 erg per coulomb. These are the units. This is about electric potential difference, and next one, electric potential due to a single point charge. Here we are considering one single point charge, then what is the equation for electric potential? Observe here, let Q naught be the test charge. Here this Q naught be the test charge placed at a point P, at a distance x from the source charge Q naught. This is the test charge here, Q naught. It is at a point P placed at a distance x from the source charge. Now already you knew what is the force between these two charges. This is represented in this direction, F equal to Q naught into E bar, and also this force is in this direction. And now work done to move this charge Q naught, this test charge, from the point P to this distance, small distance Q, through dx. Against this force, force is in this direction. If you want to move this charge this test charge Q naught from here to from point P to point Q, you have to move against the force. Against the force. Force in this direction, but you have to move in the opposite direction. That is given by dW equal to F dot dx here, F dot dx. F already you knew, Q naught into E dx. Otherwise, dW equal to Q naught into Q naught E dx cos theta. This is dot product here, then dE dx cos theta, and here angle is 180 degree, then cos minus 1, then minus Q naught E into dx. This is the dW. dW equation, and already you knew what is the equation for E, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. That is dW minus here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q naught by X square, Q by X square. This equation, electric field equation, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by X square. Here distance is X. That's why here X square, otherwise R square. Here Q Q naught 4 pi epsilon naught X square into dx. Then therefore E equal to E, already you knew this equation, in this equation substituted. Now how much work is done in order to bring this small distance dx? Now I want to know what is the workload in order to bring this test charge from point P to at a distance B. That means from here to here. Otherwise, from infinite to this distance. This B is at a distance R from the source charge. What is the work done? Then in order to know what is the work done, then integrate that system. W work done from infinite to B, limits infinite to B dW. Already dW you knew the equation. This substitute in this equation here. Infinite to R Q Q naught 4 pi epsilon naught X square dx, and here minus Q Q naught 4 pi epsilon naught integral infinite to R 1 by X square into dx. Already you knew integral 1 by X square into dx equal to minus 1 by X, and they substituted here in this equation Q Q naught 4 pi epsilon naught minus 1 by X, then here minus and here minus, minus into minus become positive. Then that equation is here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q naught by R, then divided by that using test charge, then you will get it the equation. What is the electric potential due to a single point charge? Observe here V equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. This is the equation for electric potential due to a single point charge. That is, whenever you are bringing unit positive charge, here test charge Q naught, from infinite to A, this point near to this point source charge B, what is the electric potential? V equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. Now, second case, here we are considering only one charge. If it is number of charges, like the system of charges from here, like this. This is the source charge here, Q. Source charge here, Q. For example, here system of charges, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, like that, system of charges. Then, what is the electric potential? Observe here, what is the electric potential? Electric potential due to a group of point charges. Here, more number of charges, that is representing here Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, like that, n number of charges. Then, what is electric potential? Already you knew, if it is more number of charges, how you are going to calculate? In the case of Coulomb's law of attractive forces, already we studied. And similarly, here you have to observe the net electrostatic potential at a point in the electric field due to a group of charges. The charges are here Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 and Q1 is algebraic sum of the their individual potential at that point. Here you have to observe this one algebraic sum. Algebraic sum means if it is Q1 is positive, then V1 also positive. Q2 is negative means potential also negative. That is the meaning of algebraic sum. Here we are taking all positive charges, that is V1, V2, V3, V4 up to Vn, then 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught I equal to 1 to n Qi by Ri. And in terms of position vector, this is representing 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught I equal to 1 to n Qi by R minus Ri. This is the representation of potential in terms of vector form. Note down some point here. Electrostatic potential at a point due to a charge is not affected by the presence of other charges. That means if it is single charge or n number of charges also not affected by, if it is group of charges also there is no change. If it is single point, it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R, and n number of charges also same 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. And electric potential at point due to charges not affected by the presence of other charges. And potential is here V is inversely proportional to 1 by R. Inversely proportional to 1 by R. Whereas Coulomb's force, if you are comparing this electric potential and Coulomb's force, then force is inversely proportional to 1 by R. Here electric potential is inversely proportional to 1 by R. And potential is a scalar quantity, force is a vector quantity. And potential is called as the potential at a point. It is actually equal to the potential difference between the points near points R and infinity. This is about the electric potential due to a group of point charges. Here you have to observe one thing. If it is single, due to a single point charge, equation is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. If it is group of charges also, that source charge is not affected. If it is group of charges also, that is one point. Another one, potential varies with the distance inversely proportionally, but inversely proportional to, it is varying inversely. And here potential is a scalar quantity. And this is about electric potential due to a group of point charges. And observe here there are two cases. Observe here all these cases V1, V2, V3. A surface at every point, equipotential surface. In this case, we are considering this is one, another one. In this surface, all points potential due to charge distributed uniformly, it is called as a equipotential surface. That means if you are taking this surface, in this surface anyway potential is same. At every point of which the potential due to charge distribution is the same. Here they are taking three systems, one surface, one surface, two surface, three. In this all planes potential is same. This is plane equipotential surface. Now observe here in this another diagram here from this center you have to move anywhere in this circle, potential is same. Here from here to here, or here to here, or here to here, or here to here, anywhere potential is same. This is called as a spherical equipotential surface. Now if it is distributed uniformly throughout the surface, potential is distributed, test charge is distributed uniformly throughout the surface. Then it is called as a equipotential surface. If it is not distributed uniformly, if it is not distributed uniformly, that means, for example, if you are taking one surface, potential at this point is not same, in this case it is equipotential surface, and another one is not equipotential surface. That depends on how the charge is distributed uniformly. If the charge is distributed uniformly throughout the surface, then equipotential surfaces, otherwise not equipotential surfaces. And another one observe here, already up to now we discussed electric potential, electric field in different cases, but in order to calculate electric potential or electric field, we are doing up to now, in order to solve that, we are taking one system, for example point charge, otherwise group of charges, otherwise one electric field due to a line of charge or electric field due to a circular ring. All these cases we are doing that integration in order to derive the electric field. Now we are going to discuss another theorem that is given by Gauss theorem. That Gauss theorem, by using that Gauss theorem, different cases we are going to calculate electric field. First of all, what is the Gauss theorem and how to calculate Gauss theorem for particular shape, and how to derive Coulomb's law from Gauss law, that we will discuss now. Observe here, in order to calculate Gauss theorem, in order to derive the Gauss theorem, before going to derive that Gauss theorem, you know some of the fundamental vectors. This one, area vector, electric flux, and what is solid angle. You know, before going to derive that, you have some basic idea about this, what is electric flux and what is the area vector and what is solid angle. Then it is easy to understand that Gauss theorem. Now observe here, small area of a surface can be represented by a vector. Here they are taking, this is the small area, in this is the surface, and they are taking only this small area ds, that represented by area vector ds bar, and the ds bar is given by ds into n cap. And second one is electric flux, already you know that one, how many number of electric lines of force pass through that any particular shape, that is given by electric flux. Here electric flux linked with any surface is defined as the total number of electric lines of force that normally pass through that surface, electric lines of force. Observe here, when you are considering one surface, here this is the surface S, and electric field lines of force from this here to here in this direction, electric lines of force represented by capital E, electric lines of force. And what is the electric flux? Now electric flux defined as how many number of electric lines of force pass through that surface normally, and that is represented by d pi. Here d pi equal to E dot ds, then E ds cos theta, the total electric flux. Now how many number of lines, here all these lines are entering here and going in this surface, and here ds equal to in this direction, this is the surface, this surface normally in the, like this, that is given by here this one, and this ds theta, the electric flux over the whole surface S due to an electric field complete this surface is represented in surface integral of E dot ds and E dot S this one. Surface integral of this complete, what is the surface integral of this complete area into E dot ds. See, this is surface integral E dot ds, that is given by E s cos theta E dot ds. Electric flux is a scalar quantity, but it is a property of vector field, and what is the unit for this electric flux is given by Newton meter square per coulomb, otherwise joule meter per coulomb. This is electric flux. That means how many number of electric lines of force passed when you are considering. For example, this is the surface. How many number of electric lines of force are passing through this surface normally like this? This is the surface. Electric lines of force are passing from this to here. How many number of electric lines of force are passed through this surface normally? That is given by electric flux. Electric flux, that is defined as d pi equal to E dot ds. D pi equal to E dot ds. Now, derivation of this. Now, observe here three points. Already you knew phi equal to Es cos theta. Phi equal to Es cos theta. Now, electric flux when theta is in between 0 to 90. Theta is there in between 0 to 90. Then electric flux is positive. Electric flux is positive. For example, theta is exactly equal to 90. Then electric flux is 0. And for theta here 90 to 180, it is negative. You have to observe all these points here. This is the same. Electric lines of force are passing in this shape, entering and passing here, and now electric flux is in this direction, normal to the surface, ds here, this is the theta. Now, this theta is from 0 to 90. This is, in this case, it is positive. That is in between, exactly 90, it is 0. Flux is 0. Flux is positive when theta is in between 90 degrees. When exactly 90, theta equal to 90 degree, then cos theta cos 90 0, then flux is 0. There is no electric lines of force normal to that surface. If it is 180, that means from here to here in this, then electric lines of force are, flux is negative. Flux is phi is less than 0, that is negative here. And these are the three cases you have to observe in the case of electric flux. Electric flux. What is the value when theta equal to 0 to 90? In that case, electric flux is positive. If it is exactly 90, electric flux is 0. And if it is 90 to 180, electric lines of force, that is electric flux is negative. Electric flux is negative. That means that electric lines of force are passing normal to that surface. Generally, in the case of 90 to 80, this electric lines of force are passing opposite, negative direction to the normal. These are the three cases you have to observe in the case of electric flux. And now, another one, what is solid angle? What is the solid angle here? Solid angle is the three-dimensional equivalent of an ordinary two-dimensional plane angle. Observe here, solid angle is three dimensional equivalent of an ordinary two dimensional plane angle, and here that is represented by d tau. SI unit of solid angle is the steradian. SI unit of solid angle is steradian. That is defined as the three dimensional equivalent of an ordinary two dimensional plane angle. Already if it is two, this is plane angle, already you knew. If it is the plane x and y, what is the angle here? Plane angle. And this plane angle here, three dimensional equivalent of an ordinary two dimensional plane angle, and solid angle subtended by area element ds at the center O of a sphere of radius r, that is given by here d tau. Here solid angle subtended by an aerial element, this is the aerial element ds, at the center O of a sphere of radius r, this is the sphere of radius r, is given by d tau equal to ds cos theta by r square. Now from this d tau, tau is given by integral d tau, surface integral, and surface integral ds cos theta by r square, that equal to 4 pi steradian. This derivation, we are using this in the case of derivation of Gauss theorem. This one, just you remember what is solid angle definition, and this integral is giving 4 pi steradian. Now observe here what is Gauss theorem gives. The surface integral of the electric field intensity over any closed hypothetical surface is called as Gaussian surface. In free space, it is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times charge enclosed in that surface. Gauss theorem is given by, otherwise Gauss theorem is defined as total flux through any closed surface is equal to the 1 by epsilon naught charge enclosed in that surface. That is represented here, phi equal to E dot ds, already you knew this one, and 1 by epsilon naught I equal to 1 to n q I. And how you are going to prove this theorem, this Gauss theorem is giving flux through any closed path is equal to the 1 by epsilon naught times charge enclosed in that surface. Now proof of Gauss theorem, here we are taking this surface, and here positive charge plus q, the radius of this sphere here r, and here this is the small area ds element, and this normal to this area, this is representing like this, and electric field also in the same direction. Now already you knew d pi equal to e dot ds, electric field is equation is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square, r dot ds into n bar, and this ds normal to this surface, that is n bar, and d pi equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q dot ds, q ds by r square, r dot into n. Here observe, here this two r cap and n cap, here r cap and n cap, one into one, cos both are in the same direction, this r cap is in the same direction, n also in the same direction, then r dot n, r n cos theta, both are unit vectors, 1 into 1 cos 0, then 1, then d pi equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q ds by r square, d pi equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q ds by r square. Now substitute that value, phi equal to integral d pi 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square, and here this is the integral surface integral here, integral ds, that is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. And what is the surface integral of this sphere? Ds equal to 4 pi, this radius r square, 4 pi radius r square. Then this 4 pi r square, this cancel. Then what is the value? Q by epsilon naught. That means total electric flux through this closed surface area is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times charge enclosed in the surface. This is the proof of Gauss theorem. This is the proof of Gauss theorem. Here we are considering one area, that is sphere, and radius of the sphere is r, and here small, in this sphere we are considering small area ds element, small element ds. The ds is in this direction, normal to the plane, this, and electric field also in the same direction, electric field also in the same direction. And by using this electric field equation, substituting that value here, and we will get it finally, this pi equal to q by epsilon naught. Already this is the definition for Gauss theorem. That is electric flux through any closed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times charge enclosed in that surface. This is about Gauss theorem. And observe here, now proof of Gauss theorem for a closed surface of any shape, of any shape. Now previously we discussed if it is in the sphere shape. Now this is different one, any space. See here, this is not a sphere, some particular shape, this one. How you are going to prove this Gauss theorem? Already here we are considering this is the solid angle d tau, and small area we are considering here, that is ds. Ds is in this direction, and n cap, ds is in this direction, and r cap is here, n also in the, both are in the same direction, electric field and r in the same direction, n cap also in the same direction. Now what is d pi? D pi already you knew definition, e dot ds, e is 1 by 4 pi epsilon r q by r square, r cap dot ds into n, then 1 by 4 pi epsilon q ds by r square, r dot n, r dot n already you knew, 1 into 1 cos theta here. And in the proof of Gauss theorem, both r and n are in the same direction, but here r and n are in not in same direction. Then d pi equal to 1 q by 4 pi epsilon naught ds cos theta by r square. Here previously r dot n cos theta, theta is 0, in that case cos 0 equal to 1, r dot n equal to 1. But here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q into 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught ds cos theta by r square. Now this is the case when you are considering small element. In order to calculate total flux, you have to integral throughout this surface. Then surface integral d pi 1 by 4 pi q by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q outside, and integral of this d tau, integral of this d tau. And this is already you knew, this one ds cos theta by r square equal to d tau, integral of d tau also already you knew, that is 4 pi. Now substitute q by 4 pi epsilon naught by into this integral of d tau equal to 4 pi, 4 pi 4 pi get cancelled, then here pi equal to q by epsilon naught, that is the definition. Pi equal to how much charge encoded in that surface, 1 by epsilon naught times that charge. This is the proof of Gauss theorem in any shape. And observe here another one, how to deduction of Coulomb's law from Gauss law. How you are getting Coulomb's law? By using this Gauss theorem. Already you knew from Gauss law, already you know equation pi equal to e dot ds q by epsilon naught. And here both here ds, r bar and n cap are in the same direction, r bar and n cap are in the same direction. Since electric field and ds also in the same direction, then this pi e dot ds eds pi eds pi eds, that one integral pi eds equal to q by epsilon naught. Otherwise here already you knew phi e surface integral ds q by epsilon naught. This surface integral value already you knew, that is e into 4 pi r square. Here surface integral ds equal to 4 pi r square. Here r is the small r square. That is in surface integral of this sphere, that is given by 4 pi r square. Here they are substituting that value, e surface integral, that is 4 pi r square. Already q by epsilon naught you knew. Then this 4 pi r square comes to this side. Then e equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. This already you knew. E equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. Now, if the charge q naught is placed at any point where e is calculated, then. Now, here I am keeping another charge here. For example, here I am keeping another positive charge q naught. Then force solid you knew, F equal to here another test positive test charge, force F equal to q into e in, q naught into e, then that becomes F equal to q naught, and what is the e? E is from here. Q by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. This already you know, this equation what it represents? Coulomb's law. If the two charges at rest q and q naught, what is the electrostatic force of attraction between the two charges? That is given by F equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught by r square. This is Coulomb's law. This is the derivation of Coulomb's law from Gauss theorem. Here we are using Gauss law, and finally we are deriving this equation, Coulomb's law, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q, for 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught by r square. This is the derivation of Coulomb's law from Gauss theorem. Don't confuse here. This is the definition for Gauss law. And in this definition, what we are doing? This is definition from Gauss law. This is a definition. And what we are doing here? E dot E and ds are in the same direction. Then this E ds cos theta cos 0 equal to 1. E ds integral E ds equal to q by epsilon naught. Now what? In the case of this ds here, e into integral ds, that integral ds is in the case of sphere, that is 4 pi r square. We are substituting this 4 pi r square here in this equation, e into 4 pi r square q by epsilon naught. Then for this 4 pi r square will come this side, then this is the equation, electric field 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. Now if I am keeping another charge q naught anywhere here on the sphere, anywhere here or here or here, anywhere another this one, then what is the force from this? This is the source charge, this is the test charge. From here, what is the force? That F equal to q naught into e, F equal to q naught into e, F equal to q naught into e, and substitute this e value in this equation, then we will get to this F equal to q naught. This equation represents e, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q source charge, q naught test charge, 4 pi r square. This already you knew, equation for Coulomb's law. This is the derivation of Coulomb's law from Gauss theorem. And in this session we discussed about definition of electric potential and electric potential due to a point charge. and electric potential due to a summation of charges, and what are the basic definitions for, in order to derive Gauss theorem, what are the basic, that is area vector and solid angle. After that, Gauss theorem, proof of Gauss theorem, and derivation of Coulomb's law from Gauss theorem. In this, if you have any doubt, please contact, this is my email ID, rama.natk@gmail.com, and my mobile number, and okay, thank you.